Hello all, I am Dr. Krishnaveni, final year radiology PG from Arubarai Veedu Medical College and Hospital. Title for my paper presentation is Celiac Artery Trunk, Common Hepatic Artery and Renal Artery Anatomical Variants Detection, Prevalence and Association Analysis with Multi-Detector CT. Introduction: Anatomical variants of the hepatic artery and celiac trunk are of prime importance in liver transplantation, laparoscopic surgery, radiological intervention, and penetrating injuries to the abdomen. The chance of inadvertent or iatrogenic vascular injury rises in the event of aberrant anatomy. Presence of renal artery variation is significant in surgical management of renovascular hypertension, renal transplantation, and interventional radiological procedures, where it is important to know the origin and cause of these arteries. Aim of the study is to determine the anatomical variant of celiac axis, hepatic artery, renal arteries, and the pervasiveness with the use of contrast-enhanced MDT-CT. Each arterial system was individually defined and recorded using Flacker's classification system for celiac artery and Michael's classification for hepatic arteries. The renal arteries were assessed with respect to their origin, number of arteries, and laterality. The association of renal and celiac hepatic artery variation is statistically evaluated. A retrospective observational study has been conducted with 500 consecutive cases from May to September 2021, and the sample size is 500 with the gradient echo, bright speed, elite 16 slice, 16 scanner. The inclusion criteria includes all age groups with both sexes who are all referred for the contrast enhanced MDCT abdomen. Exclusion criteria with the patient of having history of major upper abdominal surgery, patients with occlusion of celiac, hepatic, and renal arteries. Scans were performed in the axial scans axis starting from the domes of diaphragm up to the pubic symphysis, first in plane followed by contrast multiphysics scans, and the slice thickness is 5 mm, rotation time is 0.8 seconds. Retrospective reconstruction parameters were also taken. So the results and observation: it is most commonly seen in males with 57%, and variants of celiac trunk is seen predominantly in males. Hepatic artery showed a predominance of males, and renal artery variants are seen most commonly in females. Celiac trunk variants, celiac bifurcation was considered more and seen more compared to celiomycetic trunk, celiac quadrification, and others. So celiac trunk variation was classified according to Flacker's classification, where in 465 number of cases had classical celiac trunk trifurcation followed by hepatosplenic trunk, hepatogastric trunk, etc. So renal artery variation, left accessory renal artery was seen most commonly, that is 80, and the renal artery variation in 331st cases of patient had normal anatomy followed by two renal arteries on the right, then on the left. Hepatic artery variance, 39 was seen in the replaced left hepatic artery originating from the left gastric artery followed by accessory left hepatic artery originating from the left gastric artery, then replaced right hepatic artery originating from the SMA. So hepatic artery variation were classified using Michaels, where 381 cases had normal anatomy followed by replaced left hepatic artery originating from the left gastric artery. So celiac or hepatic artery variation without renal artery variation was seen in 89 cases, 89 positive cases. And celiac or hepatic artery variation with renal artery variation is seen in 65. So in our retrospective study, in 500 patients, there was normal trifurcation of celiac trunk in 465 patients, that is 93%. Hepatosplenic trunk and gastrosplenic trunk in 15 patients, quadrification in 5 patients, celiomycetic trunk in 1 patient, and other variants seen in 14 patients. Hepatic artery variations were present in 119 patients and renal artery variation in 166 patients. Results: celiac trunk or hepatic artery variation was present in 89 of 334 patients with no renal artery variation and in 65 of 166 patients with renal artery variation. There's an increased prevalence of celiac hepatic artery variation in individuals with accessory renal arteries. Now we will see the cases. Case 1 and case 2 shows the quadrification of the celiac trunk. Case 3, case 4, and case 5 and case 6 shows the splenic artery and hepatic artery separates origin from the aorta. Post-contrast MIP-CT image in transaxial section shows the separate origin of common hepatic artery and directly from the aorta at the same level, agenetic celiac axis with congenital narrowing an elephant trunk is seen in case 6. Is cause of common hepatic and splenic artery was made. In case 7, we are seeing a common hepatic artery originating from the aorta. It is also demonstrated in the volume rendering CT. In case 8, we can see the common hepatic artery arising from the SMA. It is also demonstrated in the case 9. Case 10 and 11 shows the case 10 shows the right hepatic artery originating from the celiac trunk, and case 11 shows the right hepatic artery originating from the aorta. So case 12, two accessory right renal arteries and one accessory left renal arteries are noted. Case 13 shows the accessory right renal artery, and case 14 shows the accessory left renal artery. So in our study, celiac trunk and hepatic artery variants had showed a higher incidence in males, whereas renal artery variants showed a peak incidence in female. Celiac trunk trifurcation was seen in 93% and 7% showed variation comparable with 4.5% according to the Cornfell et al. Celiac trunk bifurcation was seen in 3%, quadrification in 1%, celiac mesenteric trunk in 0.2% and others in 2.8%. Accessory renal arteries were common on left than on right. Celiac trunk or hepatic artery variations were present in 334 patients with no renal artery variations and in 65 of 166 patients with renal artery variation. This denotes a statistically significant correlation between hepatic celiac and renal artery variation. Such similar associations has been reported previously in the study done by Worrell et al. Thus, our study indicates that there may be some common factor associated in causing variation in two unrelated arterial system during embryogenesis. So coming to the conclusion, the anatomy and variation of the celiac trunk, hepatic artery and renal artery need to be established at preoperative imaging to minimize the iatrogenic arterial injury that could occur during organ transplantation, laparoscopic surgery, radiological abdominal intervention, endovascular procedures, surgical treatment of penetrating injuries to the abdomen and surgical treatment of renovascular hypertensions. These are my references. Thank you.